We now welcome back Brother Colin Calmiano to give us a talk. Yesterday, Brother spoke about God's forgiving love, and today he's going to continue and talk to us about the healing of our emotions and the love of God that heals our emotions.
Hello. Yeah, can you just raise your hands, those of you who have finished your confession, please? Yeah. Good number. Those who haven't, can you raise your hand too? Oh, okay. Okay, thank you. Okay. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Right hand, hallelujah.
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 You know, it seems once there were three Catholics. They were riding on a bike. They met with an accident and all three died. They were from Pune. And they all went to heaven and Saint Peter greeted them. So Saint Peter said, "Welcome, my boys. Enjoy heaven. Enjoy peace. Enjoy its tranquility. But there is only one thing that you should not do. Only one thing that you should not do." And they asked him, "Peter, what we cannot do?" So Peter said, "There is one thing you cannot do. Don't step on the flower garden. Don't step on the flower garden." They said, "Oh, beautiful. That's pretty simple." So they were enjoying heaven, beautiful place, enjoying the presence of God, until one guy stepped on the flower garden. The minute he stepped on the flower garden, Saint Peter came and held his hand. And he looked for the most ugliest woman in heaven. And he chained her to his hand for life. The other two saw it and said, "Whoa, I better be careful. I didn't come to heaven for this." So they were extra careful until the second guy too stepped on the flower garden, and Saint Peter came, held his hand, looked for the ugliest woman in heaven, chained him to her hand for life. The third guy, super cautious. He was super cautious. Life went on for him. He made sure he didn't step on a flower garden. But suddenly one day, Saint Peter came and held his hand, and he brought the most beautiful, gorgeous woman in heaven to him and chained his hand to her. And this guy was shocked. He said, "Peter, what have I done to deserve such a gift?" And Saint Peter told him, "Not because what you did, because what she did." He was the ugliest guy in heaven, huh? Yeah, it's a story, yeah? Don't worry, yeah? Be careful, huh? Nothing like that is going to happen to you, yeah? It's afternoon session. I thought, you know, I'm not good at singing, yeah? Where is Robert? Robert. Okay. Come.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Being an afternoon session, you know, we'll do it like this. I want to sing a song. It's a very simple song. Very simple song. We know it. We sing it in the church. It goes like this.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Praise be the Lord. Sing it again. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Praise be the Lord. Lord.
Praise be the Lord.
Everybody.
Hallelujah.
Praise be the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise be the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise be the
Lord. It's too low for me because I'm not professional. Huh? Yeah, okay.
Hallelujah, 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 praise be the Lord.
Everybody, come on.
Hallelujah, 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 praise be the Lord.
Praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
praise.
Simple, right? Hello? Say something. Okay, now we're going to do this. The people to my right. Yeah? When we sing hallelujah, you will stand. The people to my left, when you say praise the Lord, you will stand, they will sit down. Hello? Are you with me? Hallelujah, you stand. Praise the Lord, you stand, you sit. Huh? Hello? Shall we try? Ready? Ready? One, two, three, four.
Praise be.
No, 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 no. Hallelujah.
Huh?
Hallelujah. We'll sing hallelujah. Yeah. No, no. Yeah, don't worry. He's not had his lunch, so you can forgive him, okay? One, two, three, four.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Praise be the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
praise be the Lord,
praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
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 hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
praise be the Lord.
Lord,
praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
praise be the Lord,
hallelujah,
praise be the Lord.
Give a clap to Jesus, say hallelujah, hallelujah. Please stand, sisters and brothers. Can you look to Jesus this afternoon as we come into his presence once again? Look to Jesus. Close your eyes if you like, but whatever it is, just look to Jesus. Let him be the center. He is our Prince. He is our God, a loving God, a forgiving God. Jesus is here this afternoon, so look to him. Forget everything else. Shut out all distractions, sleepiness. Just drive it out. And say, Lord, I want to listen to your word this afternoon. Welcome the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters. Welcome the Holy Spirit, that he is our teacher. The Holy Spirit can enlighten us. He can make us attentive, receptive to the word of God. Look to Jesus, the Holy Spirit. Welcome, Holy Spirit.
Welcome.
Everybody, raising your hands too.
We are in your presence. We are in your presence.
Fill us with your power.
Fill us with your power. Live inside of me.
You're the living waters.
You're the living waters.
Never drying fountain.
Comforter and counselor.
Take complete control. Sing it again.
You're the living
waters. drying fountain.
Never drying fountain.
Comforter and counselor.
Comforter and counselor.
Take complete control.
Take complete control.
Raising our hands and our hearts to the Holy Spirit. Welcome, Holy Spirit.
Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. We are in fill us with your power. Live inside of me.
Oh Lord, we want to thank you. Thank you for this beautiful day that you blessed us with. Oh, as we come before you, Lord, we pray that you will continue to minister to us. We continue to bring healing to us, Lord. Continue to speak your word that can liberate us, can free us, break every bondage in our life, every addiction in our life. Oh, Lord, speak that word to us this afternoon. That word will liberate us, Lord. They'll set each one of us free, Lord, from any kind of inhibition, any kind of something, anything that is bothering us, Lord. Oh Lord, we turn to you. You are the prince of our lives. It is in you there is freedom. It is you who said, Lord, you will know me and the truth will set you free. Oh Lord, we come to you. You have the words of everlasting life. To whom shall we go, Lord? We come to you, Lord. We ask you this afternoon that you speak into each one of our lives, Lord. Mary, our mother, we ask you to pray for us. Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you very much. Please be seated. Sisters and brothers, you know, I'm trying to use the PowerPoint. I'll be using some of the screen. So if you like, for better attention, you can look at the screen. Sisters and brothers, we have come to a point where we are going to pray and ask Jesus in a very special way this afternoon to bring healing to our lives. To bring healing in our lives. We have heard a talk this morning on sin. We heard on repentance. We went for confession. And now we are sitting with us. Yes, confession reconciles to God. But there are wounds in our lives. There are some wounds in our lives. Probably some of us have been battling this over many, many days, years in our lives. We want to open our lives. We want to open our heart. We want to open specially our past to God. So that Jesus can come into our past life, that secret area of our life, that private area of our life. Nobody knows certain areas of our life. Even the best friend doesn't know some areas of our life. But today we want to do one thing. We want to give Jesus that permission to show us our past, open our lives, open our wounds, so that we can become free people. We want to be free people. That is the essence of the gospel. The essence of the gospel is that we become people who are completely, totally free. Because if there is bondage, addiction in our lives, sin in our lives, it means still we have not experienced total freedom in our lives. And we want to experience freedom in our lives this afternoon, so that our lives will never be the same. So my teaching, I call it healing our emotions. You know, what we're going to do is, we want to gain some kind of common understanding of how our emotions work. Yeah, we want to learn also how an effective approach to harnessing emotions such that they're helpful and not disruptive. We all have emotions. You agree with me? Hello? Okay, do one thing. Turn to your brother. Turn to your sister. Yeah? And say, have a good afternoon. Not to put them to sleep. Look to one another. Don't look at me and say, have good afternoon. Yeah? We have, turn to your brother. Yeah? Turn to your brother and turn to your sister and say, you have emotions. You have emotions. Sister, you also say, I hope you have, huh? Yeah? Okay. We all have emotions, but we want to know how can we harness, control our emotions. Some emotions are disruptive. It disrupts our life. And we want to talk about that. Emotions that are not very good. Emotions that have disrupted our lives. Emotions that have shattered our lives. Emotions which has weighed us down, put us down, and we are struggling to live even as a human being. And so we want to see some of the approaches, you know. We want to learn how to handle some typical emotional difficulties, unruly desires. We are young people, yeah? So unruly desires, some thoughts are going in, not very good. Yeah, they shouldn't be there, but they are there. And sometimes what I don't want to happen, happens, right? I had a friend. This is in my days of college. And we were in the same prayer meeting. We were in the same prayer group. And he had to cross a movie theater before coming to college. And this movie theater in Bangalore was a notorious theater. It had all the vulgar posters there. And opposite the movie theater is a church. So, you look at the poster, go to church. You come out, you see the poster, you go to church. So, sometimes you have to live in the church only. Now, this guy, you know what this guy did? He used to come to our prayer meeting. And, you know, some of our desires, for example, lustful feelings. Yeah? We all are human beings. Every single man and woman will have lustful feelings. Somebody tells you, I don't have such feelings. He must be a concrete pillar. No emotions. Crazy fellow. Yeah? Or he's denying. Or he's living in denial. He may be living in denial. So this guy was coming every day to the prayer meeting. He had to cross this movie. And you know, in our teachings we said, hey, listen, lust is sinful. Looking at a bad picture is sinful. So this guy is to come on his cycle and he'll be praying, Lord, I don't want to look at the poster. 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 And he looks like that. When the movie theater comes, ha! Oh my God. Then again next day, Lord, I don't want to look at the poster. I don't want to look at the poster. Ha! Oh my God. You see, sometimes what we do not want to do, we do. St. Paul had this problem. St. Paul said, the things I want to do, I do not do. The things I do not want to do, I do. Why? Emotions. Sometimes emotions are good, but if the emotions get a better, if it gets the better of you, not good. Yeah? Unruly desires. Bad self-image. How many young people suffer from a bad self-image? I knew I had this girl in my class in the university. She used to walk like this. So in my class, they called her duckling because she walked like a duck. Poor thing. And what happened to her is this settles in our mind. The unconscious mind, the subconscious mind, after some time, you start believing that what people tell you, that is what you are. Bad self-image. Hey friends, have you heard of Michael Jackson? Hallelujah. bishop? Okay, I thought you know Michael Jackson better than the bishop. You know, Michael Jackson had a bad self-image. Superstar, remember? Michael Jackson is a super... One second. He's a superstar. Everybody loved him. He's a superstar. Once, I was watching on the BBC television, his show, half an hour show. Just amazing. Absolutely amazing. The crowd is packed. And the minute he comes on the stage, women are crying, girls are crying, some are fainted. They waited for 1 hour to see him. When they saw him, they're fainting. The power that guy had. You know, Michael Jackson is a recluse. Who's a recluse? A recluse is one who withdraws from society. He withdraws. Yes, he comes and performs on the stage and he withdraws. Look at Michael Jackson. He never liked himself. He never liked himself. He did cosmetic surgery. He tried to change the color of the skin. He tried to change the way he looked. He didn't like the way he looked. He never came to a Kairos convention, you know. And really, I'm honest, if he had come to a Kairos convention, Michael Jackson would have been a man who accepts himself. And when you accept yourself, you will live for Jesus. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that's why, after some time, he changed his voice. After some time, you didn't know Michael Jackson was male or female. He had a problem. You see, bad self-image. And sometimes, as a young man, as a young woman, we try to imitate a lot of people. You know why? Because we don't accept the way God has made us. We don't. We have not heard this truth that God loves us as we are. God loves us as we are. You don't have to change. You don't have to change to be accepted by God. You don't. Because God accepts you as you are. Bad self-image. Therefore, we have to make sure we invite the Lord today. Unruly desires, bad self-image, irrational guilt feeling. How many young people have I met? They did something wrong in the past. It follows them like a shadow. Doesn't go. Struggling. Guilt. Something sexual. Something on the internet. A bad relationship, a physical relationship, guilt comes in, you're smashed. Yeah? Uncontrollable anger and fear. Have you found this? How frightened we can become. I have seen people who will scream when they see a cockroach. When the cockroach flies into the room, they fly out of their own room. Have you noticed it? Yeah. My daughter is 9 years old and she has this problem. The other day my daughter screamed. I thought the house was on fire. I went to Marika, said, Marika, what happened? Dada, look at that ant. Not normal, right? Not normal to have such fears. I know people who fear water. I know this girl who never will enter a swimming pool. Even baby pool, she will not enter. Fear of water. How many people are afraid of blood? You know, I've seen people, when they see blood, tuck, they faint. And such people should not become a nurse, right? Such people shouldn't become a nurse. Before treating the patient, she will faint. So we have this problem of fear. How to control it? How to control it? That's the reason we want to make sure that Jesus comes, brings healing in our emotions. Emotions are important. You can never be the man. You can never be the woman if you don't let Jesus come into your life, bring healing to your emotions. Because if Jesus heals you of your emotions, you will be a free bird. Free person. Free person. But remember, it's a journey. All of us suffer from fears, and therefore we want to come to Jesus this evening and ask Jesus to bring healing. What is emotional healing? If you can look at the screen. Yeah, what is emotional healing? Let's define it. John Wimber says, emotional healing is a process in which the Holy Spirit brings forgiveness of sins and emotional renewal to people suffering from damaged minds, wills, and emotions. It's a process. What is going to happen today is, after this session, when we pray for the prayer of inner healing, emotional healing, a process has begun. Jesus has begun to work in your life. Healing is beginning to work in your life. He will heal you of your mind, wills, emotions. He will forgive you of your sin. That's why Jesus, you know, many times. You know what he told people the first thing? Yeah, your sins are forgiven. And sometimes we have this guilt. I did something, I wonder, will ever God forgive me? And today, at the evening session, or after this teaching, when inner healing is done, you will realize, yes, if you open your heart to God, if God comes into your life, brings healing into your life, there will be no problem in your life. You can relate to God. You can relate to God. And that's why it's called emotional healing. Yeah, let's skip this. Look at the screen. How our mind is made. Yeah, look at the screen. Our minds are made like this, right? The conscious mind, one third. Subconscious mind, unconscious mind, two third. Where does all our hurt, unruly feelings, guilt, fear, anxiety, past experiences, where does it go and settle? It goes and settles in the two-thirds, unconscious and subconscious mind. Only one-third is conscious. That's why, do you realize, we can't remember much. We can't remember much. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit, who is also called the finger of God, to tell us exactly where we need freedom and healing in our lives. And that's what we're going to do in this afternoon, yeah? So let me put it like this. Look at this picture there on your screen. 88% is the unconscious mind. 88% is the unconscious mind. It is here, during this evening, we're going to ask Jesus, invite Jesus to come into this area of our lives, touch us, bring healing to us, so that we are free from our past. It's an amazing session. That's why I want you to listen well. Yeah, if you have anything that is coming to your mind, if the Lord brings something to your mind during the session, maybe fear, uncontrollable desires, lust, it can be bitterness, it can be anger, it can be wrong relationship, it can be premarital sex, it can be abuse. Write it down. Because during the time of inner healing, you can show God, you can show Jesus your life. Say, Jesus, this is my life. This is my life. Nobody knows it. My best friend doesn't know it. But only one person will know it this evening, and that is Jesus. If you open your life, show him your wound, show him your hurt, show him your bitterness, you will be healed completely and totally. Yeah, so, can you see this? The conscious mind is like the tip of an iceberg. The tip of an iceberg. Just 12%, 88% is submerged. Cannot see it. It's underwater. Nobody knows it. Sometimes even you wonder, why are you like this? Because 2/3 of your life is submerged. You know, ask a sailor, ask a captain on a ship what they fear most on a voyage. You know what they fear most on a voyage? An iceberg. An iceberg. Because they just don't know how large it is, how big it is. All they see is the tip. And then their heart will be beating. Because they just don't know how much of distance they need to keep away from the iceberg. Sisters and brothers, our lives are like that. What we see of our lives is the tip of the iceberg, but what controls our life is 2/3 of our life, our subconscious life, unconscious life. It drives my life. It drives it. Have you ever thought sometimes, hey, why do I behave like this? I know some people, when they see a particular person in their life, they get angry. They get angry. Something happened in the past. Some people are not even aware of their feelings. They are angry, but they don't know. So you tell them, hey, you are angry. And they will say, who said I'm angry? Because he is not in control of his feelings. He just doesn't know what is happening in his life. Yeah, why? It drives your life. It propels your life. 2/3 of your life is submerged. We are saying today, we need to open that area of our life to Jesus, who can same yesterday, today, and forever, so that Jesus can come into that area, that wound, that painful experience, that trauma, and he can set you free completely and totally. Can you look at the screen? Yeah. Very, very nice diagram. Huh? It says conscious, subconscious mind. Remember, conscious mind 12%, subconscious mind 88%. Hey, what does the conscious mind control? What does the conscious mind control? You know what it says here? Planning. I use my mind to plan. But again, it's only 12%. That's why, have you noticed, we plan something, we end up with something else after some time, right? Because it's only 12%. Our planning also is not perfect. Willpower. How often we find people who say, I am not going to smoke. I met people like this. Yeah? During Lent, they make this commitment. During Lent, they make this commitment. They make a promise. I am not going to smoke for 40 days and after that too. Willpower. After Lent, they smoke double. Easter Sunday is freedom. I met a friend of mine. He's from this country called Bahrain. He told me, my uncle is an alcoholic. But it's amazing that in the 40 days of Lent, he can give up alcohol. 40 days. But on Holy Saturday, they have to go in Bahrain searching for the guy. Because, had what he didn't have for 40 days and he's sleeping on the pavement. They have to carry him home. Yeah? Why? Willpower does not work. Willpower does not work. That's why you and I need the assistance of the Holy Spirit. No wonder the Holy Spirit is called the helper. He comes to help us. Help us. Critical thinking, short-term memory comes from the conscious mind. Short-term memory. My dear sisters and my dear brothers, when do we know we have a short-term memory? At a convention. Because the previous talk, we already forgot. I don't blame you. Short-term memory. Nothing can happen. Yeah? I want you to get into unconscious mind. Hey, what does the unconscious mind control? Habits and patterns. Habits and patterns are controlled by the unconscious mind. Yeah. Habits. Have you seen some people? Whenever they see food, they can eat. It's amazing. Some people's appetite is just amazing. The way they eat, you'll be wondering if you have abundance of food here. Yeah. Call them anytime for a treat, they are always willing. Gluttony. They habits. Procrastination. Putting off things is the habit and a pattern that is formed in the unconscious, controls your life. Habits. Sexual sins. Masturbation. Yeah? It's unconscious. We cannot. Struggling. How many people are a slave to a sexual sin? Young people. Slave. Can't do anything much with it. So it's very important for us to make sure that, you know, we bring these areas before the Lord. Patterns, habits, laziness. I have a friend. He's working in the corporate sector. You know what his wife tells me? She tells me, brother, when Saturday comes, my husband does not get up from the bed. He sleeps right through Saturday. So I told her, let me give you a solution. Next time if you see him sleeping in the bed, pour a bucket of iced water on his head. He will not even sleep on Sunday because of the headache. Yeah, some people are like that, no? Nothing to do at home? Sleep. They're less. Look at habits and patterns. Emotions are controlled by the unconscious mind. Creativity is controlled by the unconscious mind. Why do we need healing? We live in an imperfect world. No man, no woman is perfect. Yeah, no man, no woman is perfect. We live in an imperfect world, which we all suffer from damaged minds, wills, and emotions. We are wounded people. We are wounded people. And that's why we want to come to the Lord, the greatest healer, the greatest physician, this afternoon, because we are wounded people. We are broken people. We have a past. Our past drags us down, and therefore we have to make sure we want to ask God to bring healing in our lives. Let me share something personal in my life. You know, when I was a total introvert. Can you believe it? Now I'm on the stage. I always struggled to meet people. Even during my college picnic, I used to never go to my college picnic. I always told my classmate, oh, I am not feeling well. But that's not true. I just didn't know how to interact, how to relate to other people. I withdrew. I had a very close circle of friends, 3-4 friends. Apart from that, I just couldn't. I couldn't. And so, when I made my first retreat many, many years back, I got into this prayer group. And I shared this with a friend of mine. He's my mentor. And he said, Colin, it's not normal. It's not normal for somebody like you to be an introvert, withdraw completely, not relate to people. So he said, you know, why don't you ask your mother? Why don't you ask your mother what she went through during the conception? And now this is very difficult, right? I can't go to my mother and say, Mama, what happened, Mama? Crazy, right? It's a dicey issue. So I was praying. I said, Lord, if you can give an opportune time for me to speak to my mother needs to be open to me so that she can tell me. And if it is something that will release me, give freedom in my life, then create this situation. And it came. It came. One day my mother was there. I was alone at home. I sat with her and just asked her this question. I said, Mama, what happened? What happened? What did you go through when you were expecting me? I have a sister, older sister. She is 18 months older to me. 18 months. So my mother, so beautiful. You see, this is the grace of God. Yeah, my mother, you know what she told me? We felt you came too soon. And I said, oh my God, it's not my fault, right? Anyway, they said, hey, you came too soon. So they thought or contemplated of getting rid of me. Yeah, but I was born. Look at me. Yeah, and when I went to my mentor immediately, and I told my mentor, hey, you know, this is what my mother says. Oh, wow, this is the light of God. It's a serious issue. Let's pray. So my mentor took me through one-to-one inner healing. What I'm going to do this evening is praying on a general group like this. But he made me sit opposite himself, took me through inner healing for the specific area of my life so that I could forgive my mother. I could forgive my mother. I was asked to forgive my mother. I had to forgive my mother. And you know what happened? I walked out of the session a changed man. So much so, when my friends saw me the next day, they were shocked. They said, what's happened to you? I said, why? What happened? Your face is glowing. I said, wow. Say hallelujah. 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 Raise the right hand. Come on. Please. Hallelujah. 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 Hey, that's what healing does, right? You know what healing does? It dispels darkness. Light comes. More free. You'll start smiling better. Yeah. So, sisters and brothers, we are affected at the time of our conception. Yeah. Let me. Yeah. We are wounded from the time of our conception. If you want to look at the screen. Yeah, many people can experience a conception due to rape, verbal abuse, being conceived before marriage. You see? Conception. What is conception? All that the mother goes through in the 9 months is transferred to the baby. We call it what? Internal transfer to the baby. Have you seen some people? Always sad. Have you seen them? Very sad. They're good looking, pretty looking, handsome, but sad. Mother of all sorrows. Cannot laugh. Always sad. You know what we call it? A melancholy spirit. Sorrow, sadness. Maybe your mother went through sorrow, sadness for one reason or the other. It got transferred to the baby. We need healing. We need healing. I have to ask the Lord to come into our lives, into this loneliness. Loneliness. How many people suffer from loneliness? I met couples who thought the answer to loneliness is marriage. They got married even more lonely. And that's why they soon after marriage, they also get a pet at home. Why? Because of loneliness. Maybe your mother went through it, transferred to the baby, not healed. You know, that's why it's called Kairos, right? Your God's favor, God's opportune time, so that we can bring our feelings, bring our emotions, show it to the Lord, and the Lord can bring healing in our lives. In a mother's womb, we can experience shock and stress experienced by the mother. Maybe the time of birth. It can be a difficult birth, long labor, cesarean birth, forceps were used. All this will affect your life. Will affect your life. And that's why we are the way we are. Ask the Holy Spirit. Pray to the Holy Spirit. During this entire session, pray and say, Holy Spirit, please show me my past because I want to make sure God heals me. Infancy and childhood. Yeah, infancy and childhood. It can be traumatic, isn't it? Infancy and childhood for some people. Death of a mother. Imagine losing your mother when you're young. Ah, it's terrible. Losing your father when you're young. It will crush you. You'll grow But what I'm trying to say is, there is an emptiness, there is a wound, it's a painful experience, trauma. Only Jesus can heal. I know this guy, boy, 5 years old, he witnessed his father getting murdered in front of him. They actually butchered him, the father. Imagine, what trauma. Cannot sleep, unforgiveness, bitterness. That's why father was saying, hey, we have to make sure inner healing is never complete without forgiveness. Somebody hurt you. Somebody killed your parents. Maybe a boyfriend or girlfriend ditched you. I know your problem. Yeah, painful. It's painful. It's emotion. We have to release. Pray for forgiveness. Pray. You know, I was in Calcutta once preaching a retreat. And this girl is in the retreat. And right through the sessions, this girl is crying. Crying. Uncontrollably. Every session, I got curious. I was wondering, why is she crying? Is she crying because of me? So I went to her and I said, you know, after the session, I said, why are you crying? Why are you so sad? Then she told me a story. She says, you know what a story is? This girl fell in love with a neighbor. The Bible says, love your neighbor. So this girl took God seriously, his word seriously, fell in love with a neighbor. This guy promised her to marry her. He went to the US, forgot her. She's crying. Painful. And so, on the side, I had to pray with this girl. Did the same thing. Did inner healing for her. Jesus healed her completely and totally. She was a new person after that. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is our God. Whenever Jesus steps into the life of a young man and the life of a young woman, you know what he do? He will bring freedom. He'll bring freedom in our lives. Death of a mother, father, brother, sister, any car accidents, fire, economic hardships, financial crisis in the home, inability to learn to spell at school. I know how many people are made fun of their people. Hey, they don't know how to spell. Apple. A-P-P-L-E. This person writes A-B-B-L-E. What to do? Yeah. Right? So, they need healing. People made fun. Hey, she doesn't know A for apple. Poor thing. She only knew one thing. How to eat it. And so, look at this. I want you to look at the screen. Adolescents. Probably you're in this area now. Adolescents. A very traumatic area. We experience a lot of emotions. We can be wounded in the process of developing our sexuality, in the process of becoming an adult. This is a time we experiment, right? Yeah, we experiment. Many people experiment with sex. We want to know what it is. One guy said, we want a little experience, brother. How foolish thinking, isn't it? The worldly thinking. Yeah? The worldly thinking. Yeah, this is the problem. We have been wounded by a boy. We have been wounded by a girl. Yeah. Hey, you know, let's be honest. All of us here, including the first two rows, we might not have had a relationship, but surely we experienced a crush. I liked that girl. She didn't like me. Huh? She likes me, I didn't like her. Yeah, that's Bollywood, no? Yeah. Somebody's chasing me, I am chasing somebody else. So what happens? Ultimately, three people get hurt. We face rejection. Yeah, we face rejection. That's why during this process, our sexuality, that how many young people have been abused? Abused sexually. That uncle, an auntie, a cousin took advantage of a person, abused the person. It's trauma. It's trauma. You cannot forget it. It will never go until this evening. You come before Jesus. You come before Jesus. Somebody molested you. Somebody called you bad names. Somebody tarnished your character. It's painful. Painful. And therefore, we want to come to God. We want to come to God. And ask God, Lord, come and bring healing in my sexuality, in my relationships, so that we become the people God wants us to become. Very quickly, yeah. So what is inner healing? Inner healing is simple. Yeah, Father's going to lead us. I'm not too sure how Father will do it. But one thing Father will do, He will ask you to invite Jesus into that pain, into that wound, into that memory, so that Jesus comes and brings healing in your life. He's inviting Jesus into the town, asking Jesus to walk into your life. Why? Only Jesus.
Check. Check.
Okay, so inner healing is asking Jesus to walk into our past life, bringing healing and cure. Only Jesus can do this. Nobody can do this. No human being can do this. You know why? Jesus is the same yesterday and today and forever. So wherever you are, whatever may be your past, remember one thing. There is nothing that is impossible for God. Nothing. Nothing. Don't put any conditions. Don't say, you know, my condition is so bad. Can I come before Jesus? Of course. We know that woman, right? Mary Magdalene, Father was sharing, right? Yeah. But Jesus forgave her. And that's why, let's skip all this, yeah? In scripture, did Jesus do inner healing? Surely. There's two scriptures. Mark chapter 2, 1 to 5. Jesus healed the paralytic man. He said, son, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. He healed the paralytic man. Because sin can weigh on us, bring guilt, make us feel ashamed, make us feel bad. And here Jesus saying, your sins are forgiven. Luke 17, 11 to 19, the 10 lepers. To the one who came back to thank Jesus, you know what Jesus told him? Rise, go your way. Your faith has made you well. Your faith has made you well. This total healing, this complete healing. My dear sisters and brothers, God is calling us to bring healing. And so some steps are, we finish confession. Most of us have finished confession. Father gave a talk on repentance, you know, and we have repented of all our sins. Forgiveness, Father gave again, I can't go into it. Forgiveness, to forgive people who have hurt me. I am a victim. My people have experienced, I've hurt. I need to forgive people and pray to the Holy Spirit to fill the wound with the love of Jesus. Say hallelujah. Right hand, please. Hallelujah. 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 Can you please stand for a minute before we pray, and we'll ask them to get ready for the inner healing service, but we want to pray. Just look to Jesus. Wherever you are, don't get distracted. Look to Jesus. Look at, if you can see the screen too. Look to Jesus. Jesus is more important. I want to ask the TV man, can you focus, sir? Can you focus on the cross, crucifix? Yeah, thank you. Jesus. Look at Jesus. 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 Wherever you are. Can we raise our hands to Jesus? As we raise our hands, we are raise our lives to Jesus. Past, present, and even our future. And as we raise our hands today, we want to tell Jesus, Jesus, I give you permission. I give you permission. Come into my life. Touch any area in my life. I give you the permission to touch any area, any wound, any pain, any trauma, any wrong relationship. Give Jesus. Look at him and say, Lord, I give you this permission. Touch me. Transform my life, Lord. Heal me completely and totally, Lord. For all the pain, the hurt, the trauma. Oh, Lord, heal my memories, Lord, too. Heal my memories. That I may be the son, I may be the daughter that you have made, so that I can truly worship you, Lord, with a freedom in my heart. Raise your hand to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Say everybody, hallelujah, Lord. Praise your name, Lord. Bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. May your name be blessed, Lord. May your name be glorified, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you very much. Please be seated.
Give a round of applause and a hand of praise to our Lord for the word we have received through Brother Colin. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We go into a short 20-minute break now. This break is mainly to prepare ourselves for the healing we're going to receive. After this, we will go into adoration before the Blessed Sacrament. And so this break is only for us to prepare ourselves and to spend some time in prayer, to allow the Lord to reveal those areas in our life where we need healing. So I request you to remain here, remain seated, unless you absolutely need to go and freshen up and come back.
Suffer from a bad self-image. I knew I had this girl in my class, in the university. She used to walk like this. So in my class, they called her duckling, because she walked like a duck. Poor thing. And what happened to her is, this settles in our mind, the unconscious mind, the subconscious mind. After some time, you start believing that what people tell you, that is what you are. Bad self-image. Hey friends, have you heard of Michael Jackson? Hallelujah. Do you know your bishop? Okay, I thought you know Michael Jackson better than the bishop. You know, Michael Jackson had a bad self-image. Superstar, remember? Michael Jackson is a super... One second. He's a superstar. Everybody loved him. He's a superstar. Once I was watching on the BBC television, his show, half an hour show, just amazing, absolutely amazing. The crowd is packed, and the minute he comes on the stage, women are crying, girls are crying, some are fainted. They waited for 1 hour to see him. When they saw him, they're fainting. The power that guy had. You know, Michael Jackson is a recluse. Who's a recluse? A recluse is one who withdraws from society. He withdraws. Yes, he comes and performs on the stage and he withdraws. Look at Michael Jackson. He never liked himself. He never liked himself. He did cosmetic surgery. He tried to change the color of the skin. He tried to change the way he looked. He didn't like the way he looked. He never came to a Kairos convention, you know. And really, I'm honest, if he had come to a Kairos convention, Michael Jackson would have been a man who accepts himself. And when you accept yourself, you will live for Jesus. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that's why, you know, after some time, he changed his voice. After some time, you didn't know Michael Jackson was male or female. He had a problem. You see, bad self-image. And sometimes, as a young man, as a young woman, we try to imitate a lot of people. You know why? Because we don't accept the way God has made us. We don't. We have not heard this truth that God loves us as we are. God loves us as we are. You don't have to change. You don't have to change to be accepted by God. You don't. Because God accepts you as you are. Bad self-image. Therefore, we have to make sure we invite the Lord today. Unruly desires, bad self-image, irrational guilt feeling. How many young people have I met? Yeah, they did something wrong in the past. It follows them like a shadow. Doesn't go. Struggling. Guilt. Something sexual. Something on the internet. A bad relationship, a physical relationship, guilt comes in, you're smashed. Yeah? Uncontrollable anger and fear. Have you found this? How frightened we can become. I have seen people who will scream when they see a cockroach. When the cockroach flies into the room, they fly out of their own room. Have you noticed it? Yeah. My daughter is 9 years old and she has this problem. The other day my daughter screamed. I thought the house was on fire. I went to Marika, said, Marika, what happened? Dada, look at that ant. Not normal, right? Not normal to have such fears. I know people who fear water. I know this girl who never will enter a swimming pool. Even baby pool, she will not enter. Fear of water. How many people are afraid of blood? You know, I've seen people, when they see blood, tuck, they faint. And such people should not become a nurse, right? Such people shouldn't become a nurse. Before treating the patient, she will faint. So we have this problem of fear. How to control it? How to control it? That's the reason we want to make sure that Jesus comes, brings healing in our emotions. Emotions are important. You can never be the man. You can never be the woman if you don't let Jesus come into your life, bring healing to your emotions. Because if Jesus heals you of your emotions, you will be a free bird. Free person. Free person. But remember, it's a journey. All of us suffer from fears, and therefore we want to come to Jesus this evening and ask Jesus to bring healing. What is emotional healing? If you can look at the screen. Yeah, what is emotional healing? Let's define it. John Wimber says, emotional healing is a process in which the Holy Spirit brings forgiveness of sins and emotional renewal to people suffering from damaged minds, wills, and emotions. It's a process. What is going to happen today is, after this session, when we pray for the prayer of inner healing, emotional healing, a process has begun. Jesus has begun to work in your life. Healing is beginning to work in your life. He will heal you of your mind, wills, emotions. He will forgive you of your sin. That's why Jesus, you know, many times. You know what he told people, the first thing? Yeah, your sins are forgiven. And sometimes we have this guilt. I did something, I wonder, will ever God forgive me? And today, at the evening session, or after this teaching, when inner healing is done, you will realize, yes, if you open your heart heart to God, if God comes into your life, brings healing into your life, there will be no problem in your life. You can relate to God. You can relate to God. And that's why it's called emotional healing. Yeah, let's skip this. Look at the screen. How our mind is made. Yeah, look at the screen. Our minds are made like this, right? The conscious mind, one third. Subconscious mind, unconscious mind, two third. Where does all our hurt, unruly feelings, guilt, fear, anxiety, past experiences, where does it go and settle? It goes and settles in the two thirds. Unconscious and subconscious mind. Only one third is conscious. That's why, do you realize, we can't remember much. We can't remember much. That's why we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit, who is also called the finger of God, to tell us exactly where we need freedom and healing in our lives. And that's what we're going to do in this afternoon, yeah? So let me put it like this. Look at this picture there on your screen. 88% is the unconscious mind. 88% is the unconscious mind. It is here, during this evening, we're going to ask Jesus, invite Jesus to come into this area of our lives, touch us, bring healing to us, so that we are free from our past. It's an amazing session. That's why I want you to listen well. Yeah, if you have anything that is coming to your mind, if the Lord brings something to your mind during the session, maybe fear, uncontrollable desires, lust, it can be bitterness, it can be anger, it can be wrong relationship, it can be premarital sex, it can be abuse. Write it down. Because during the time of inner healing, you can show God. You can show Jesus your life. Say, Jesus, this is my life. This is my life. Nobody knows it. My best friend doesn't know it. But only one person will know it this evening, and that is Jesus. If you open your life, show him your wound, show him your hurt, show him your bitterness, you will be healed completely and totally. Yeah, so, can you see this? The conscious mind is like the tip of an iceberg. The tip of an iceberg. Just 12%, 88% is submerged. Cannot see it. It's underwater. Nobody knows it. Sometimes even you wonder, why are you like this? Because 2/3 of your life is submerged. You know, ask a sailor, ask a captain on a ship, what they fear most on a voyage. You know what they fear most on a voyage? An iceberg. An iceberg. Because they just don't know how large it is, how big it is. All they see is the tip. And then their heart will be beating. Because they just don't know how much of distance they need to keep away from the iceberg. Sisters and brothers, our lives are like that. What we see of our lives is the tip of the iceberg. But what controls our life is 2/3 of our life, our subconscious life, unconscious life. It drives my life. It drives it. Have you ever thought sometimes, hey, why do I behave like this? I know some people, when they see a particular person in their life, they get angry. They get angry. Something happened in the past. Some people are not even aware of their feelings. They are angry, but they don't know. So you tell them, hey, you are angry. And they will say, who said I'm angry? Because he is not in control of his feelings. He just doesn't know what is happening in his life. Yeah, why? It drives your life. It propels your life. 2/3 of your life is submerged. We are saying today we need to open that area of our life to Jesus, who can same yesterday, today, and forever, so that Jesus can come into that area, that wound, that painful experience, that trauma, and he can set you free completely and totally. I want you, sorry, can you look at the screen? Yeah, very, very nice diagram. It says conscious, subconscious mind. Remember, conscious mind 12%, subconscious mind 88%. Hey, what does the conscious mind control? What does the conscious mind control? You know what it says here? Planning. I use my mind to plan. But again, it's only 12%. That's why, have you noticed, we plan something, we end up with something else after some time, right? Because it's only 12%. Our planning also is not perfect. Willpower. How often we find people who say, I am not going to smoke. I met people like this. Yeah? During Lent, they make this commitment. During Lent, they make this commitment. They make a promise. I am not going to smoke for 40 days and after that too. Willpower. After Lent, they smoke double. Easter Sunday is freedom. I met a friend of mine. He's from this country called Bahrain. He told me, you know, he said, my uncle is an alcoholic. But it's amazing that in the 40 days of Lent, he can give up. He can give up alcohol. 40 days. But on Holy Saturday, they have to go in Bahrain searching for the guy, because, you know, had what he didn't have for 40 days and he's sleeping on the pavement. They have to carry him home. Yeah? Why? Willpower does not work. Willpower does not work. That's why you and I need the assistance of the Holy Spirit. No wonder the Holy Spirit is called the helper. He comes to help us. Help us, you know. Critical thinking, short-term memory come from the conscious mind. Short-term memory. My dear sisters and my dear brothers, when do we know? When do we know we have a short-term memory? At a convention. Because the previous talk, we already forgot. I don't blame you. Short-term memory. Nothing can happen. Yeah? I want you to get into unconscious mind. Hey, what does the unconscious mind control? Habits and patterns. Habits and patterns are controlled by the unconscious mind. Yeah. Habits. Have you seen some people? Whenever they see food, they can eat. It's amazing. Some people's appetite is just amazing. The way they eat, you'll be wondering if you have abundance of food here. Yeah. Call them anytime for a treat. They're always willing. Gluttony. They habits. Procrastination. Putting off things is the habit and a pattern that is formed in the unconscious, controls your life. Habits. Sexual sins. Masturbation. Yeah? It's unconscious. We cannot. Struggling. How many people are a slave to a sexual sin? Young people. Slave. Can't do anything much with it. So it's very important for us to make sure that, you know, we bring these areas before the Lord. Patterns, habits, laziness. I have a friend. He is working in the corporate sector. You know what his wife tells me? She tells me, brother, when Saturday comes, my husband does not get me give you a solution. Next time if you see him sleeping in the bed, pour a bucket of iced water on his head. He will not even sleep on Sunday because of the headache. Yeah, some people are like that, no? Nothing to do at home? Sleep, sleep, sleep. They're less. Huh? Look at habits and patterns. Emotions are controlled by the unconscious mind. Creativity is controlled by the unconscious mind. Why do we need healing? We live in an imperfect world. No man, no woman is perfect. Yeah, no man, no woman is perfect. We live in an imperfect world, which we all suffer from damaged minds, wills, and emotions. We are wounded people. We are wounded people. And that's why we want to come to the Lord, the greatest healer, the greatest physician, this afternoon. Because we are wounded people. We are broken people. We have a past. Our past drags us down. And therefore we have to make sure we want to ask God to bring healing in our lives. Let me share something personal in my life. You know, when I was a total introvert. Can you believe it? Now I'm on the stage. I always struggled to meet people. Even during my college picnic, I used to never go to my college picnic. I always told my classmate, oh, I am not feeling well. But that's not true. I just didn't know how to interact, how to relate to other people. I withdrew. I had a very close circle of friends, 3-4 friends. Apart from that, I just couldn't. I couldn't. And so, when I made my first retreat many, many years back, I got into this prayer group and I shared this with a friend of mine. He's my mentor. And he said, Colin, it's not normal. It's not normal for somebody like you to be an introvert, withdraw completely, not relate to people. So he said, you know, why don't you ask your mother? Why don't you ask your mother what she went through during the conception? And now this is very difficult, right? I can't go to my mother and say, Mama, what happened, Mama? Crazy, right? It's a dicey issue. So I was praying. I said, Lord, if you can give an opportune time for me to speak to my mother needs to be open to me so that she can tell me. And if it is something that will release me, give freedom in my life, then create this situation. And it came. It came. One day my mother was there. I was alone at home. I sat with her and just asked her this question. I said, Mama, what happened? What happened? What did you go through when you were expecting me? I have a sister, older sister. She is 18 months older to me. 18 months. So my mother is so beautiful. You see, this is the grace of God. Yeah, my mother, you know what she told me? We felt you came too soon. And I said, oh my God, it's not my fault, right? Anyway, they said, hey, you came too soon. So they thought or contemplated of getting rid of me. Yeah, but I was born. Look at me. Yeah, and when I went to my mentor immediately, and I told my mentor, hey, you know, this is what my mother says. Oh, wow, this is the light of God. It's a serious issue. Let's pray. So my mentor took me through one-to-one inner healing. What I'm going to do this evening is praying on a general group like this. But he made me sit opposite himself, took me through inner healing for this specific area of my life so that I could forgive my mother. I could forgive my mother. I was asked to forgive my mother. I had to forgive my mother. And you know what happened? I walked out of the session a changed man. So much so, when my friends saw me the next day, they were shocked. They said, what's happened to you? I said, why? What happened? Your face is glowing. I said, wow. Say hallelujah. 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 Raise the right hand. Come on. Please. Hallelujah. 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 Hey, that's what healing does, right? You know what healing does? It dispels darkness. Light comes. More free. You'll start smiling better. Yeah. So, sisters and brothers, we are affected at the time of our conception. Yeah. Let me. Yeah. We are wounded from the time of our conception. If you want to look at the screen. Yeah. Many people can experience a conception due to rape, verbal abuse, being conceived before marriage. You see? Conception. What is conception? All that the mother goes through in the 9 month is transferred to the baby. We call it what? Internal transfer to the baby. Have you seen some people always sad? Have you seen them? Very sad. They're good looking, pretty looking, handsome, but sad. Mother of all sorrows. Cannot laugh. Always sad. You know what we call it? A melancholy spirit. Sorrow, sadness. Maybe your mother went through sorrow, sadness for one reason or the other. It got transferred to the baby. We need healing. We need healing. I have to ask the Lord to come into our lives, into this loneliness. Loneliness. How many people suffer from loneliness? I met couples who thought the answer to loneliness is marriage. They got married, even more lonely. And that's why they soon after marriage, they also get a pet at home. Why? Because of loneliness. Maybe a mother went through it, transferred to the baby, not healed. You know, that's why it's called Kairos, right? Your God's favor, God's opportune time, so that we can bring our feelings, bring our emotions, show it to the Lord, and the Lord can bring healing in our lives. In a mother's womb, we can experience shock and stress experienced by the mother. Maybe the time of birth, it can be a difficult birth, long labor, cesarean birth, forceps were used. All this will affect your life. Will affect your life. And that's why we are the way we are. Ask the Holy Spirit. Pray to the Holy Spirit. During this entire session, pray and say, Holy Spirit, please show me my past, because I want to make sure God heals me. Infancy and childhood. Yeah, infancy and childhood. It can be traumatic, isn't it? Infancy and childhood for some people. Death of a mother. Imagine losing your mother when you're young. Ah. It's terrible. Using your father when you're young, it will crush you. You'll grow. But what I'm trying to say is, there is an emptiness. There is a wound. It's a painful experience. Trauma. Only Jesus can heal. I know this guy, boy, 5 years old. 5 years old. He witnessed his father getting murdered in front of him. They actually butchered him, the father. Imagine what trauma. Cannot sleep, unforgiveness, bitterness. That's why father was saying, hey, we have to make sure inner healing is never complete without forgiveness. Somebody hurt you. Somebody killed your parents. Maybe a boyfriend or girlfriend ditched you. I know your problem. Huh? Yeah, painful. It's painful. It's emotion. We have to release. Pray for forgiveness. Pray. You know, I was in Calcutta once preaching a retreat. And this girl is in the retreat. And right through the sessions, this girl is crying, crying uncontrollably. Every session, I got curious. I was wondering, why is she crying? Is she crying because of me? So I went to her and I said, you know, after the session over, I said, why are you crying? Why are you so sad? Then she told me a story. She's, you know what a story is? This girl fell in love with a neighbor. The Bible says, love your neighbor. So this girl took God seriously, his word seriously, fell in love with a neighbor. This guy promised her to marry her. He went to the US, forgot her. She's crying. Painful. And so, on the side, I had to pray with this girl. Did the same thing. Did inner healing for her. Jesus healed her completely and totally. She was a new person after that. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is our God. Whenever Jesus steps into the life of a young man and the life of a young woman, you know what he do? He will bring freedom. He'll bring freedom in our lives. Death of a mother, father, brother, sister, any car accidents, fire, economic hardships, financial crisis in the home, inability to learn to spell at school. I know how many people are made fun of their people. Hey, they don't know how to spell. Apple. A-P-P-L-E. This person writes A-B-B-L-E. What to do? Yeah. Right? So, they need healing. People made fun. Hey, she doesn't know A for apple. Poor thing. She only knew one thing, how to eat it. And so, look at this. I want you to look at the screen. Adolescents, probably you're in this area now. Adolescents. A very traumatic area. Traumatic area. We experience a lot of emotions. We can be wounded in the process of developing our sexuality, in the process of becoming an adult. This is a time we experiment, right? Yeah, we experiment. Many people experiment with sex. We want to know what it is. One guy said, we want a little experience, brother. How foolish thinking, isn't it? The worldly thinking. Yeah, the worldly thinking. Yeah, this is the problem. We have been wounded by a boy. We have been wounded by a girl. Yeah, let's be honest. All of us here, including the first two rows, we might not have had a relationship, but surely we experienced a crush. I liked that girl. She didn't like me. Huh? She likes me, I didn't like her. Yeah, that's Bollywood, no? Yeah. Somebody's chasing me, I am chasing somebody else. So what happens? Ultimately, three people get hurt. We face rejection. Yeah, we face rejection. That's why during this process, our sexuality, how many young people have been abused? Abused sexually. That uncle, an auntie, a cousin, took advantage of a person, abused the person. It's trauma. It's trauma. You cannot forget it. It will never go until this evening. You come before Jesus. You come before Jesus. Somebody molested you. Somebody called you bad names. Somebody tarnished your character. It's painful. Painful. And therefore, we want to come to God. We want to come to God and ask God, Lord, come and bring healing in my sexuality, in my relationships, so that we become the people God wants us to become. Very quickly, yeah. So what is inner healing? Inner healing is simple. Yeah, Father's going to lead us. I'm not too sure how Father will do it. But one thing Father will do, he will ask you to invite Jesus into that pain, into that wound, into that memory, so that Jesus comes and brings healing in your life. He's inviting Jesus into the town, asking Jesus to walk into your life. Why? Only Jesus.
check. Check.
Okay, so inner healing is asking Jesus to walk into our past life, bringing healing and cure. Only Jesus can do this. Nobody can do this. No human being can do this. You know why? Jesus is the same yesterday and today and forever. So wherever you are, whatever may be your past, remember one thing. There is nothing that is impossible for God. Nothing. Nothing. Don't put any condition. Don't say, you know, my condition is so bad. Can I come before Jesus? Of course. We know that woman, right? Mary Magdalene, father was sharing, right? Yeah. But Jesus forgave her. And that's why, let's skip all this, yeah? In scripture, did Jesus do inner healing? Surely. There's two scriptures. Mark chapter 2, 1 to 5. Jesus healed the paralytic man. He said, son, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. He healed the paralytic man. Because sin can weigh on us, bring guilt, make us feel ashamed, make us feel bad. And here Jesus saying, your sins are forgiven. Luke 17, 11 to 19, the 10 lepers. To the one who came back to thank Jesus, you know what Jesus told him? Rise, go your way. Your faith has made you well. Your faith has made you well. This total healing, this complete healing. My dear sisters and brothers, God is calling us to bring healing. And so some steps are, we finish confession. Most of us have finished confession. Father gave a talk on repentance, you know, and we have repented of all our sins. Forgiveness, Father gave again, I can't go into it. Forgiveness, to forgive people who have hurt me. I am a victim. My people have experienced, I've hurt. I need to forgive people and pray to the Holy Spirit to fill the wound with the love of Jesus. Say hallelujah. Right hand, please. Hallelujah. 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 Can you please stand for a minute before we pray and we'll ask them to get ready for the inner healing service, but we want to pray. Just look to Jesus. Wherever you are, don't get distracted. Look to Jesus. Look at, if you can see the screen too. Look to Jesus. Jesus is more important. I want to ask the TV man, can you focus, sir? Can you focus on the cross, crucifix? Yeah, thank you. Jesus, look at Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, wherever you are. Can we raise our hands to Jesus? As we raise our hands, we are raise our lives to Jesus. Past, present, and even our future. And as we raise our hands today, we want to tell Jesus, Jesus, I give you permission. I give you permission. Come into my life. Touch any area in my life. I give you the permission to touch any area, any wound, any pain, any trauma, any wrong relationship. Give Jesus. Look at him. And say, Lord, I give you this permission. Touch me. Transform my life, Lord. Heal me completely and totally, Lord. For all the pain, the hurt, the trauma. Oh, Lord, heal my memories, Lord, too. Heal my memories. That I may be the son, I may be the daughter that you have made, so that I can truly worship you, Lord, with a freedom in my heart. Raise your hand to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Say everybody, hallelujah, Lord. Praise your name, Lord. Bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. May your name be blessed, Lord. May your name be glorified, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you very much. Please be seated.